Most comedians have a stool, but I'm ill-prepared. So, brought a table from the audience that no one was using. Thank you for not using that. Yeah, I've been known to shake things up. I like to eat dinner for breakfast and breakfast for lunch. Never lunch for dinner! But my snacking throughout remains the same, because every story needs a food line. Thank you. I was recently on vacation. I went to the Wisconsin Dells. Woo! Alright. Every time I leave where I'm from, I like to pick up a rock in a new place, and leave a rock that I picked up from somewhere else, just in case someone in the future might be a geologist digging in that spot. I want them to be confused, that's it. I like to go to restaurants and eat food, sit down places where I get a dish and they ask me what kind of side I want, soup or salad. I usually say absolutely please, because from what I understand, salad is made of superfoods already. There's a super herb version of that. I fucking want it! Oh man. I bought a cheese grater. Then I ran out of refrigerator space, so I had to buy a cheese lesser. I demand to know why Pride Month hasn't yet co-opted the phrase, "Don we now are gay apparel."
Because that's all the time?
Missing out on a huge opportunity. Now I'm not gay, but I watch gay porn, so I think I'm not speaking out of turn. I was at the Mall of America a little while ago, and I was walking around, since what you do there. And there was a little set-up display area sort of a thing outside of Sears, and they were teaching CPR. And how I know that is there was someone standing there with a wireless microphone, much like this, going, "Come over here and learn how to do CPR to save a pet's life, save a friend's life, or a family member's life. It's free. It'll only take a few minutes." And I thought, I really don't trust anyone with only a few minutes of training to do anything. But then I thought about the moment that someone might need CPR in, and how they don't really check credentials. Anyone can fucking run over there. So I think the next time I'm in that situation, the next time, because I've been in that situation before, I'm worldly, I travel. I'm just gonna lie. "Help! This man's having a heart attack. Does anybody in here know CPR?" I do! What are you wasting your time? Get over here! And I'm gonna get over here. "I see a bad moon rising." CCR and CPR, two totally different things. And then a man will die. As most of you can probably tell, I don't take hallucinogens.
No.
Anymore. It's, let's just say I took acid a few times and it didn't respond well to my brain didn't respond well to it. I need order rather than chaos in order to function like a human in the world. Long story short, the third time I took acid, I urinated on my friend's couch and my other friend's backpack and a person, which is not funny. Thanks for the rest of you. I did learn some very important lessons, two main ones. One of them is don't take acid. It doesn't end well for you. The other one is that God exists, which is important because I was having doubts at that time. But God doesn't exist the way that I thought God existed. God doesn't give a shit what you think, say, or do. All God really cares about is this. Guy fucking loves that shit.
Yeah, she does.
Right. Oh, those are the jokes that work. Now what do I do? This is right. So actually, I work at the Mall of America, and sometimes I have people come in who don't speak a lot of English, mainly Spanish. Which is not a huge problem for me, because I took 4 years of Spanish in high school, which is like saying I don't speak Spanish. But I can still say the numbers, you know? I can at least do something at the end of the transaction to help it out. But every time it comes up to that moment, they look me in the eye, and they go, because they just look, they don't really say anything. And I go, 4692. And the child goes, 46.92. And I could have done that, but instead I was a douchebag, because I forgot that I'm a brown person, and speaking Spanish to someone who speaks Spanish and not English isn't racist. it's not as funny as it is a PSA. Just, you can't speak Spanish to people who don't speak English if they also speak Spanish. It'd be weird if you started speaking Spanish to a Korean person. Or a baby. All right.